One of the results of the 1913 lockout was, of course, the foundation of the Irish Citizen Army. And some of the most well-known members of the ICA were the Connolly siblings, six of them all together, which included Sean, who was killed during the 1916 Rising, and also Joe, who went on to become the chief of Dublin Fire Brigade. Here we have a number of examples of items that are included in the auction which relate to Joe Connolly. And the first that I'm going to show you here is lot 264, which has an estimate of 2,000 to 3,000 euro. It comprises of four different fire buckets altogether. Their original riveted fire buckets, which were used in the Northumberland Hotel. Of course, the Northumberland Hotel was acquired by Jim Larkin early in the 20th century, and eventually became Liberty Hall. The fire buckets themselves are extremely interesting, have a remarkable story behind them. This particular example has an inscription on the bottom. They were presented to Joe Connolly on his retirement from Dublin Fire Brigade, and the inscription gives the history of the buckets themselves. They were saved from Liberty Hall following the 1916 Rising by Rosie Hackett, another well-known member of the Irish Citizen Army, and by coincidence, who actually is in the running for the naming of the new Dublin Bridge across the Liffey at the moment. They were then kept until the 1930s, when they were then given to Joe, as I said, on his retirement. Another item that we have here, which is a fantastic piece of Civil War history, it's a letter, a typed letter, on the notepaper of the headquarters of the Dublin City Brigade of Auchlignaheron, and dated June 1922. It's signed by Oscar Traynor, and it is asking Joe Connolly, as head of Dublin Corporation Fire Brigade Ambulance, to come to the assistance of wounded who are holed up in the forecourts at the time while the battle is still raging around them. Oscar Traynor explains the situation that the people who are wounded within the forecourts are in, and says that if Joe uses his position as head of Dublin Fire Brigade to come in and save these men, that the Free State Forces will be unable to take them from him without breaching international law with regards to the treatment of casualties of war. It's a remarkable item and a remarkable survivor as well. It's the story of Oscar Traynor going and asking Joe Connolly to actually help him in the forecourts was well known, but this document backs it up and actually gives the primary evidence relating to it. So it's a great item. It's lot 317, and it's estimated at 800 to 1,000 euro. The final item that I'm going to show you here is probably the most emotive item that is actually included in the auction, in my opinion anyway. It's lot 279. It's estimated at 200 to 300 euro, and it's a letter that was addressed to Joe Connolly from New York. Unfortunately, the year is not dated, but it was still while he was in Dublin Fire Brigade. It's quite a lengthy letter. It amounts to 5 pages altogether. And to sum it up, it basically pleads with the Connolly family to come together and to try and help their brother, Eddie. Eddie was also a veteran of the 1916 Rising, and he had gone to New York. He had emigrated and found himself in very tough times. It describes the situation that he was in. He was sleeping rough on park benches in New York, and didn't have a coat, which the writer explains is a great worry, as he, or perhaps she, is worried that he won't actually even survive the winter. It's an extremely interesting letter, and something that I'm sure will attract a lot of attention during the auction. You can see more details on whites.ie. The full catalogue is there, photographs and descriptions for all the lots also.